Hey everyone, it's Chris. Today we are making low tunnels. Now, low tunnels are essentially high tunnels, but in miniature. Now, you can go online and buy low tunnel kits that come with everything that you need. What we're going to do today, though, is we're going to build our own. We have about 10-foot long poles of electrical conduit. It's about half inch in terms of its diameter, and we're going to bend it with a bender to make the hoops, which we will then stack along our rows of the garden and then cover with, first we're going to cover it with row cover, and then we'll eventually cover it with a poly plastic covering. Benders come in various forms. What I have is a 4-foot bender, so it's going to take a 10-foot long piece of conduit and it's going to bend it into a hoop that's 4 feet wide. There is also a 6-foot bender. I kind of wish I had that one because then I could have easily spanned my two beds that I want to cover. However, with this 4-foot one, I'm going to be a little short on one side. But what we use is we use electrical conduit and we use the EMT conduit. It's the cheaper kind. It has a thinner wall and it works very well for this application. So from either end, we are going to measure 16 inches in and we are going to mark where 16 inches is located, and that is what we're going to use to line up on the end of our pipe bender. So I did it this end, I'm going to the other end, I'll do it at the other end. And we insert the pipe into this side of the bender, and then here is our 16 inch mark, which we're going to line up right here on the end like that. With your mark lined up, you are then going to pull the pipe all the way around the bender. Now, this is what you do for the 4-foot one. For the 6-foot one, you would do it a little bit differently. There's more instructions on that online. You bring it all the way until it touches this other end of the bender. You remove the pipe, flip sides, and you do the exact same thing on this side. Another important thing to know when you're bending is to make sure that you keep your conduit on the same level plane. If I were to do it twisted up or down, it would be all cobby wobbled and it would not be very even and uniform. And here you have one frame to the low tunnel. We have a couple more already made, so let's go ahead and take these over to the garden. Once we get these into the garden, it's not going to take too long. It's getting close to the end of the day, so what we're going to do right now, we're just going to put them in. We're going to put some row cover over it, and then tomorrow we're going to come in. Hopefully we'll have some greenhouse poly, which we'll use to then cover the top and give us some really good winter protection. The spacing that we're going to put on these hoops is going to be about 6 foot apart. You can go 5, maybe even 4 foot if you live in an area with large amounts of snow. A lot of snow is going to put a lot of weight on these, and so the more of these hoops that you have, probably the better structural strength you're going to have. Yes, I know, it's not the most ideal setup for a low tunnel, having this bridging between these two beds, having to crawl underneath every time, but better design, better planning, could have avoided this. So we're going to be just using an old piece of row cover tonight to get us through this cold night, and we're going to secure it with these clips that go over the conduit here. And once we get our new poly, we're going to put that on tomorrow, but this will do us for tonight. That was part one of a two-part video where we bent the low tunnel frames and we installed them in the ground. Part two goes into securing them with rope, and then what do we do? How do we put the plastic over top of that? Want to see that? Put a link up here and below in the description. As always, please subscribe and share, and thank you for watching.